What's going on, everyone? It's Sam. Welcome back to the channel. Today, we have finally gotten the Eternals trailer, which kind of felt like a myth for the longest time. So I'm excited to see it. I got my buddy Colin with me here. We do the podcast together. So you ready for it or what?
Yeah, man. I'm excited to dive into it.
Let's go. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Shit looks beautiful.
Back in time, clearly.
I think that kid right there is the one that people thought was young. The actor.
It's got to be the first time there.
Speedful. Listener.
Let's go.
Guided. We have helped them progress.
It just looks so good.
And seen them accomplish wonders. Throughout the years, we have never interfered. Until now.
That's gotta be the unicorn. First look at Dane. That's gorgeous.
Thank you for this.
Oh, you're welcome.
So now that Captain Rogers and Iron Man are both gone, who do you think's gonna lead the Avengers?
I could lead them.
That was good. I liked that a lot.
So obviously I said I saw it earlier. A lot of people were saying that it felt like, you know how like with Shang-Chi we got a full type of trailer, even though it was a teaser?
Yeah.
This one like felt pretty heavily like a teaser. Like you don't really know what's going on whatsoever.
Yeah, definitely. It's more visual than anything else. I feel like we're really getting the Chloe Zhao signature look that I've heard about. I've never seen Nomadland, but from what I hear, it's all landscapes. And I mean, that's kind of what we open up with, over the water. And then that massive ship, that's the most unique ship we've seen in the MCU. Like, we haven't really 100%. Seen anything like it. It looks like it's flying without any power.
Yeah, the one interesting thing, that's got to be the first time visiting, I would assume.
Yeah, 100%. Or maybe first time for Richard Madden's character. I forget.
Oh, who that's a good point.
Yeah.
He's playing Icarus.
Icarus, yeah.
We finally got our first look at Kit Harington's character, Dane Whitman, the Black Knight, which there's one scene in this trailer, I don't know if you caught it. It looks like the Black Knight, but I can't tell. I don't know if he's going to be, you know, fully geared up or whatnot lighting. By the end.
Yeah,
I even tried to brighten it up earlier, and I for the whatever reason I couldn't picture out who it was.
Yeah, well, I mean, other than that, I love that we get the big team up shot at the end. Do you think that's from early in the movie before they go their separate ways, or do you think that's at the end when they come back together? Because like part of me thinks it'll be kind of crazy to see them all separate and come back. Would they like give away the final shot? Is that typical Marvel, like, oh, we'll show you 1 second of the ending just for the sake of it? Or is it like Hulk in the Infinity War trailer where he's never there? Like,
I think that's legit. I think that is in the first half of the movie.
Okay.
Probably before they decide to, like, well, what's his name was there? Druig. Druig was there. Yeah. I think he might be the main villain.
He
was there, so that actually might be, well, you never know, it could be Celestials, but yeah, I think that's probably in the beginning there.
To that point, like you said, like you really have no idea what the storyline is going to be, whereas like with Shang-Chi, it's, you know, here's a kid, he's going home, his dad is evil, like that's how we know the plot is being driven. I mean, all we know about the Eternals is, and it's kind of what we saw here, a bunch of different time and places, a lot of really cool and crazy powers, like the visualization too. Like, I love how this is like a whole new color, kind of staying consistent with Captain Marvel when she draws cosmic energy, but it's yellow. And I like, you know, how like chaos magic is red, you know, dark magic is purple. And I like how that color kind of pops throughout that trailer. And the animation with the, like, you know,
whatever that
like
is,
Doctor Strange glyphs, right? Yeah. Like, I have no idea. I mean, it looks insane to me, but I liked how it looked, like liquidy, metally at the same time.
Yeah, it's interesting how they're showing their powers in this. You didn't read the Jack Kirby run at all, have you?
No, I haven't.
I mean, a lot of people haven't. I did it. I probably read it about a few months ago, maybe before Christmas or so. So it's good. I mean, I definitely recommend, you know, reading it if you do have the time. If
and
not,
that's
you
what might be referencing.
Yeah.
Like a lot of the visuals.
Yeah, but it's like done differently in the MCU, of course, because, you know, it's always done differently. But
yeah,
that's really it. Other than that, yeah, I don't know. I just finally we got the trailer. We've been waiting forever. Mm-hmm. And then we thought that the last trailer that came out was going to be Eternals.
Yeah.
And ended up not being Eternals. So I'm pretty ready. I'm finally.
We didn't get a lot of Kamala's character in this.
Yeah, we didn't.
No one-liners from him. They didn't really play comedy at all, which is weird for a Marvel trailer, other than obviously that final nod to the shawarma scene, clearly.
Yeah,
I mean,
yeah,
that final scene around the table, you gotta love it. It really shows the interesting dynamics and chemistry that we're gonna get from a whole new group of characters that know each other over literally like millennia, right?
Don't yeah, they? I think
they forget each other for a bit, but it's like,
yeah, it ranges from 7,000 years back. So yeah, I don't know how they're gonna do it. I think one of the rumors is that Sprite, she has the ability to basically cause like illusions and stuff. It's kind of like the Scarlet Witch power in a way, not like, you know, fully, obviously, but
yeah.
There's a theory that she might have like brainwashed them and they're finally just coming to their senses or something somehow, maybe because of the snap or whatever.
Yeah.
And that's why they haven't been helping out. But they did say in the trailer, like, this is we haven't intervened at all until now. So what is that? Like, if you didn't do it for Endgame, what is now?
And then that would like low key mean that there'd be some crossover between the Norse gods and. Because Odin was on Earth, we know that from Thor 2, the Dark World.
And, yeah.
You know, to hide the Tesseract, to do all that stuff. You know, maybe he ran into the Eternals. I mean, that would be cool. I mean, I doubt we're going to get that at all.
That would be cool, though. I mean,
yeah.
We haven't seen Zeus or like any of these types of gods, too. And we're getting Zeus in Thor 4. So it could have a connection. I don't know. I think a lot of the cosmic stuff is kind of like we haven't done any cosmic, really. You can say Guardians is cosmic, but it's not really cosmic. It's like
cosmic adjacent.
Yeah, it's like the, I think what Gunn said, it's like the hybrid of Earthbound and space. Yeah. Like at the end of the day, where did all their main conflicts ended up on Earth? So,
yeah.
You know, but yeah, I don't know. Anything else thinking of?
No, I mean, I'm excited for the next one. I'm excited for the Loki show, see if maybe Loki, they reference the Celestials in some sort of way. But I mean, other than that, I loved it.
Yeah, me
give
too.
Me more, more, more.
I've been
more,
waiting
more,
for
please.
It forever. Next, guess what trailer's next?
Spider-Man Far or No Way Home.
Yep, No Way Home.
I'm gonna lose my mind. They better just open with all three Spider-Man just right away.
Yep.
Dude,
I said this on, I put out like a 3-minute video on Friday just talking about how.
Yeah, I saw that.
You saw it? Yeah, they're changing. Yeah. Like they're prepping for it. It's coming soon, but just please, just announce this. Just show them in the movie or in the trailer. Yeah. Like we all know it's
too
coming.
Late. Yeah.
It's whatever. Do you think they do it? I don't think they do it.
Not the first one. I think they do like Civil War. where it's like, what was that, the third trailer?
No, I think that was the second, right?
Second? I don't know.
No, wasn't it the main one? I don't know. Well, second is like the main trailer after the teaser. Oh,
before the teaser. Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, either way, who knows? I guess we'll find out.
One thing we forgot to mention, no Celestials in this trailer.
Oh, true.
I don't know if you noticed.
Yeah. None of the weird looking teaser people from the teaser picture we saw.
Yeah, no, no all Optimus of them? Prime.
Yeah,
yeah. they look like Autobots. Yeah, I mean, other than that, that'll do it. Thank you for tuning into our quick reaction here. We're going to start doing them for more trailers. We were trying to do it last time for Shang-Chi. We actually recorded the full thing. Yeah, it got messed up. So this is the first one. Thank you for tuning in, of course. If you haven't already, subscribe to the channel. If you like Marvel, the MCU, comics, everything in between, that's what we talk about here, of course. Like I said, we're going to be doing new trailer reactions in the future. I have a Loki video coming out really soon based on time travel. That's going to be a really good one, probably my favorite one I've done in a while. So tune in for that. Follow me on Twitter at Another Marvel G. You can follow Colin nowhere, right? Nowhere.
I don't exist. Nowhere.
Yeah, he doesn't exist on social media. So yeah. Other than that, thank you for tuning in. Like I said, I'm Another Marvel guy. Peace.